Hey everybody, welcome to RMS Sales Training and Inspiration. I want to say that today is a super fantastic, dynamite, exciting day, and I feel great, and I am great. I'll never get sick of saying that, and I'd like for you to say that when you wake up in the morning. When you get up in the morning, it's important that you wake up positive and you start your day off positive and that you get yourself prepared to having a great day. So I really want you to work on when you look in the mirror, how regardless of how you look, look in that mirror and give yourself a pep talk and say, you are God's child. God has designed you for great success. You are going to have an amazing day today. Your day is going to be awesome because you are awesome. God has a plan for your life, and He has a plan for you to succeed because He wants you to bless others because you are blessed to be a blessing. Imagine if you started out your day like that, and then you continued and you said, I am filled with gratitude today. This is the day that the Lord hath made. I will rejoice. And I will be glad in it. Regardless of what comes my way, whatever detours, whatever challenges, whatever obstacles, whatever comes my way, I am going to have a super fantastic, dynamite, exciting day. That doesn't mean that my life is perfect, not at all, but it does mean that I am going to have a great day. Nothing's going to get in my way. As a matter of fact, everybody that I encounter, what I'm going to do is I'm going to do my very best to make their day even brighter. If I see someone without a smile, I am going to give them one of mine. That's what I'm going to do. When I see people, I don't know what they're going through. Many people are going through difficulties. Many people are going through challenges. Many people are going through obstacles. So I'm going to treat them with kindness. I'm going to be respectful. It doesn't matter where they come from, what they look like. I am going to treat them with honor, with respect, and I'm going to give them my super positive attitude. I'm going to encourage them. I'm going to do everything that I can to lift them up. I'm going to be a blessing wherever I go. As a matter of fact, if I'm going through a drive-thru and I see someone behind me, do this today if you can. If you're going through a coffee shop, Starbucks, wherever you go. Go through the drive-thru, pay for the person behind you, and tell them that my message for them is I want them to have a super fantastic day. And the person that's in that booth can tell them, you tell them, say, make sure you say this with a smile. I'm taking care of them today. I want them to have a, can you remember this? Super fantastic, dynamite, exciting day. Repeat that. Okay, super, you got her smiling. You got her, give her a little tip, right? Make her day better or his day, whoever it is. And start spreading some enthusiasm. Start spreading some cheer and start spreading some goodwill. That's what it's all about. When I end my shows, I say, this is a day that's a gift from God. You've noticed I've said that on all the shows, and I truly believe that. Every day that we have here on this earth truly is a gift from God. So the question is, what are you going to do with this day? Whatever you do, you're giving it right back to God. So you want to bless others. You want to bless people as many as you can. And my philosophy is, while you're here on this earth, I believe this in my heart, that God wants the very best for you. He wants you to have days. He wants days of wonderful days. He wants you to have blessed days. He wants you to be successful, because by being successful, not just monetarily, but in so many different ways in your life, it's going to allow you to bless other people. Successful in your attitude, successful in your family, successful in your relationships. You want to be that type of person where when people meet you, they want to be around you. You want to be that type of person, like, all right, here comes so-and-so, as opposed to, oh no, here comes so-and-so. We don't want to be that guy at all. And we know people like that. When they walk around, say, oh no, here they come. We're going to hear a lot of negativity. We're going to hear all about the problems. We're going to hear all about, here they come again. All right, we're going to hear all about their bad stories, about all the things that happened in their life. Well, no. We don't want to be that guy ever. And again, I'm not saying we don't have difficulties or challenges or anything like that. If we have a request and we're going through a tough time, it doesn't mean that we keep all that in. We want to share that with people. Ask for a prayer request if you're a believing person and you have faith. Ask for people to encourage you. Be around the people that are going to lift you up. That's very important that you're around the right people. And I want to take part of our show to talk about that, and I also want to talk about success. So that's what this show is going to be dedicated to. Who are you surrounding yourself with? You are a product of your own environment. If you are around people that drink all the time, and you maybe you weren't a big drinker, guess what is more than likely going to happen? You will start becoming that type of person. That just happens. If you're around people that swear all the time, I've seen this happen all the time in areas that I grew up, you know, bad language and all that. And I'm not being judgmental, but I'm just saying to you that if you're around that, all of a sudden that starts coming out of your mouth, right? If you're around people that are constantly talking about other people and gossiping, that's a sin. If you're gossiping, and we can all fall into that, because it's fun to gossip. You know, it's fun to talk about other people. You know, that's just the bottom line. But if you're around people that do that, there's a chance that you're going to start doing that, because in that environment, you're saying it's okay. Now, on a side note, keep this in mind. If you're around people that talk about other people to you, I have a promise to make to you. When they're not around you, they are talking to other people about you. Get that, and please understand that. So if you're around that type of people, chances are you're going to be that type of person. You are a product of your own environment. You are who you hang around with. So I want you to check your circle of influence. Who are influencing you in your life right now? Are they taking you to a higher level? Are they encouraging you? Are they lifting you up? Do you love being around them? Are they moving you in the direction where you want to go? These are real important questions, and sometimes we have to make some tough decisions, and sometimes we have to say, it doesn't mean that we're just going to completely shut them off. It just means that we need to kind of change the circle of influence that we have. If you're ever around people and you're around them and you say, man, I just feel good when I'm around that person. Man, they just lift my spirits up. Man, they make me positive. They make me a better person. They make me reach my highest level. They help me to become a better person. They're helping me to achieve my goals. They're helping me to succeed. If you're around those type of people, they make you feel good. And that's the type of people that you want to be around. If you're starting a new opportunity, especially for those of you that are with RMS, and you begin a new opportunity like this, you're going to hear a lot of naysayers. You're going to hear people that say, you don't want to do that. I know people that have done that before. They weren't successful. There's no way you're going to be successful. Please get a job with security. Go work a different job. You're not going to make it there. I had a brother that had a sister that had a cousin that had a dog that had a brother that did that, and they weren't successful. What makes you think you're going to be successful? When you hear that constantly and you're bombarded with that, that's going to take away your confidence. That's going to take away your self-belief. That's going to take away from your self-esteem. So it's important that you surround yourself with the people that are encouraging and are going to lift you up. So that's my question before we take a short break. Who is your circle of influence? Who are you allowing yourself to influence you? Who are you hanging around with? Keep that in mind. You are a product of your own environment. Winners hang around with winners, The reality is, losers hang around with losers. Get your circle of influence to a higher level. And when you do that, that's going to take you to a higher level. Get some mentors in your life. Find the people that are in life where you want to be and follow them. Doesn't mean that they're perfect, but if they're doing it in a moral way and they have a good character and they have good respect from other people, they have a good reputation, those are the type of people that you want to emulate. Do exactly what they do. The people that aren't in life where you want to be cannot show you how to get there. Because if they knew, guess what would happen? They would be doing it. So remember that. Where's your circle? Who's your circle? Who are you surrounding yourself with? Make sure that you're bringing that to a higher level. So let's take a short break. We're going to cover a few things about that today. We'll talk a little bit about success. These are some important things. They're going to help you with this show. That's these shows that we talk about. It's sales training, but it's important along with sales training that you have inspiration. RMS sales training and, say it with me, inspiration. Inspiration, motivation. That's going to help get you to a higher level. If you have bad days, you're going through tough times, you're going through difficulties, you might be in a slump, whatever might happen, it's important that you have good encouragement and good inspiration. So let's take a short break, and we will touch more on that, and I'll be right back. Hey, it's Rich Norton here. I'm here with my good friend Sean Benson. We're up here in Atlanta, Georgia, and I want to tell you that we have amazing opportunities with Retriever Merchant Solutions. Sean, tell them all about what we do.
Well, Rich and I are in the electronic payment space. I'm sure those of you that have tuned in to Rich's amazing Retriever Inspiration video segments that we're doing here, we absolutely love the business that we're in. We go out and help clients on a daily basis. Lower their merchant service processing fees. We do it one client at a time, and Retriever Merchant Solutions has the absolute number one deliverable in the industry, without question.
And our slogan is having fun and making money. That's what we do, having fun and making money. So if you're interested in this opportunity, give me a call at 904-434-4635. We will teach you, we'll train you, we'll help you have all your dreams come true. All right, I am back, and what a great show. I'm so pleased to share this with you, because as I talk about this, it makes me question with me. And again, this doesn't mean that you just have to call all your friends up and say, hey, you're a loser, I don't want to hang around with you anymore. Don't do that. Because you'll say, yeah, Rich Norton taught me that. I watched this show, and I'm not supposed to hang around with you anymore. That is not true at all, okay? You need to love one another. You need to encourage one another. You need to hang around with them, maybe not all the time, but if someone's bringing you down, you need to question that. But you need to encourage them and lift them up as well. You know, that doesn't mean you need to just eliminate. Maybe some, if there's some that are really doing some bad things, you need to check that as well. There's some that you may need to eliminate. But again, I didn't want to paint a picture that you're just disqualifying all your people and telling them, I'm better than you, I don't want to hang around with you anymore. So please don't get this in the wrong text at all. Make sure you're understanding exactly what I'm saying. The main thing that I want you to do is to make sure that you are hanging around with people that are going to bring the best out of you. They're going to lift you up. They're going to encourage you. They're going to help you to become successful. And I heard this before. If you're the smartest person in the room, then you're in the wrong room. Okay? Remember that. So always look for people that are in a higher level than you, and look to learn from everybody. There's so much that we can learn. There's so much that I can learn. I think that joy and happiness is all part of progress and growth. When people stay stagnant and they don't move further in life, they lose their joy and they lose their happiness. And this is what happens. I've seen people retire, and I've seen that happen with my dad. He retired and he lost his focus, he lost his reason, and he lost all his joy and all his happiness, and he passed away a couple years later and got old. We talk about that. Don't let the old man in. No matter what level, because people may say to me all the time, why do you do all what you do, man? You keep so busy and you work hard. And I just say, I love to, man. I'm growing. I want to keep on growing. And it's not about money anymore. It's all about growth, because growth and progress equals joy and happiness. So if I'm still breathing and I'm still moving, I'm going to keep on growing, no matter where I'm at. I want to grow in my faith. I want to grow in my playing guitar. I'm not even near where I want to be. I want to grow in this business. I want to grow in the ministries. I want to grow in my income so I can bless other people. I want to grow in my relationships with family, grow in relationships with my friends, because progress and growth equals joy and happiness. So don't stay stagnant. Always look for ways to improve. So here are some things that I've got written down on the type of people that you want to surround yourself with. And number one, I wrote down the inspired. As we talked about earlier, RMS sales training and inspiration. We are here to inspire you. So people that are inspiring are fun to be around. You know, just like I talked about earlier, you can't wait to get around these people. And you may have said this to some representatives or some people, some with Retriever, some in the outside world. You might say, man, when I get around you, man, you just inspire me. You know, you get me excited. I just want to do great things. I know I can go to a higher level. You help me with my confidence. You help me on my sales training. Whatever it is, I love being around you. So that's the type of people that you want to surround yourself with, people that are uplifting and people that are inspiring. And I'm talking about in all phases of their life. When you look at their relationship, if they're a married couple, you want to look at that and say, man, that's it. They're not, again, it's not a perfect, no one has a perfect relationship, but you want to be around the ones that are, man, that couple really inspires me. You know, I like and I love learning from them. I love how their relationship is, and I'm picking some things up to help me with my relationships. Inspiring in the way they do ministry, inspiring in the way that they do their work, inspiring in the way that they talk to other people. They just have an inspiring whole life is what it is. So those are the type of people that you want to surround yourself with. People that are inspiring to you. People that are going to help you get to that next level in life. Just like I talked about, we're constantly growing. We're constantly getting bigger. We're constantly getting better. So surround yourself with people that are inspiring. Okay? The next one, surround yourself with people that are passionate. Very important. Successful people have passion. They have a passion for life. I talk about this a lot. They get up in the morning and they're just, it's not like, oh, another day. You know, oh, I have to do this. Oh, I have to do that. Completely change your whole way of thinking and say, I get to do this. I get to do that. I'm fortunate to do this. I'm fortunate to do that. And when you wake up in the morning, it's, today's a new day. It's not like, ugh, it's another day. I have passion. I'm passionate about today. I'm passionate about what's going to happen today. And whatever we do in life, live with passion. What a great philosophy. It's great to be around those type of people that are living with passion. They're passionate about everything in their life. They're passionate about their relationships, passionate about their business. And I share this with you a lot. I have a passion to teach people to become successful. What is your passion? Whatever it may be, get excited about it. If you're with Retriever Merchant Solutions, get passionate about this business. Get excited about this business. If you want to have great success in this industry, get passionate about it. When you're visiting merchants out there in the field, are you just going through the motions? Are you setting the example of, hey, my name is so-and-so, I'm just out here helping people, and you're going through the motions in your presentation and wondering why you're not getting much success in what you're doing, or you're getting average success, or you're saying, man, I'm just having some bad days out here. Maybe it's just the weather. Maybe it's something else. Well, maybe you're just simply not passionate enough. So get that passion back. And sports heroes do that. Music people do that. It's like all of a sudden they just go through the motions, right? Or they win a Super Bowl. The next year, they don't have a very good year. Why? Because they lost their passion. You've heard that. I've lost my passion for football. I've lost my passion for music. I've lost my passion. Well, how do you get that back? You just make the decision to get it back. And when you're out there visiting merchants, show the merchants that you have passion for what you do. When you greet them for the very first time, you're just passionate, excited about helping them. So those are the people that you want to surround yourself with. Find the passionate people. So number one, find the inspiring people. Number two, find the passionate people. And number three, find the motivated people in life. Motivation. It's like you can run across them, you say, man, that person's just motivated. And they are motivated to become successful. The unmotivated is what you don't want to be around. Because the unmotivated are going to be the type of people that are just kind of hanging out, doing the same old boring routine, the same old boring job, the same old boring stuff, and they're not making it happen. You know, those are the type of people that you don't want to be around. Find the people that are motivated to go out and make it happen. Find the people that are motivated for success. Find the people that are motivated to be winners. Find the people that are completely motivated to have success in their life, where they wake up in the morning and they'll call you up on the phone and say, man, today's your day, man. Let's get motivated. Find the people and hang around with the people that say, hey, man, you want to work out today? I'm motivated. Let's get motivated. Let's go out and work out. Hey, you want to go for a bike ride? Yeah, let's do it together. Hey, well, you want to go for a walk with me? Yes, let's get motivated. Let's get on a good plan. Hey, let's make sure we eat right. Let's get healthy. Let's get motivated. Let's do this together. And when you are together doing it, it brings out even more results. Because when you hang around with motivated people, there's a strong chance that's going to allow you to become more motivated. So we want to find people that are inspiring. We want to find people that are passionate. And we want to find people that are motivated. And then we also want to find people that are grateful. When you find people that have an attitude of gratitude, that rubs off on you. When you find people that complain all the time, that brings you down as well. It's quite the opposite. You can go to a restaurant with those type of people, and you know these type of people. They always send the food back type of people. They always complain about the service. They always complain about the restaurant. They complain about the weather. They complain about the business. They complain about the owners of the business. They complain about America. They complain about the Republican Party, the Democratic Party. They're complaining, complaining, complaining. It's never their fault. Now, do you think if you're around that a lot, that's going to rub off on you? Absolutely. And pretty soon, you fall into that trap. And then it's like, yeah, I know what you mean, man. I agree with you. I'm complaining. Yeah, this food really isn't that good. You know, let's send it back. You know, let's complain about this. Let's complain about that. Thou shall not complain. That's your commandment for the day. Thou shall not whine. Thou shall not complain. Live in gratitude. Hang around with people that have an attitude of gratitude. Imagine that. You be around those type of people and they say, man, I am so thankful. You call them up on the phone, man, I am so thankful for this opportunity. This retriever opportunity, man, it's been great for me and my family. The residuals that I got, the blessings that we have. I'm going to Cancun, Mexico in November. I'm going to Bahamas in August. Next year, I'm going to be going to another beautiful island. We're going to the Cayman Islands. Man, this opportunity is amazing. I am so grateful for what it's done for my family and the friends and all the people that I've been able to bless. What a great, great, great. I am so thankful for this opportunity, as opposed to, man, this company's not the same. And you know, it's changed. You know, see what happens? You'd be around those type of people. Yeah, he's not the same. They don't care about me anymore. Meanwhile, they got $50,000 a month in residual and they're complaining, right? The company this, the service that, this is horrible, that's horrible. That rubs off on you. And you got to be careful with who you're talking to on the phone. In this business I'm talking about as well. Be careful who you're getting your counsel from. Be careful who you're getting your advice from. Find the people that understand. Not everything's perfect, but they live in complete gratitude. They have an attitude of gratitude. I promise you, if you do that, that's going to rub off on you. And you're going to say, man, oh man, it's great to be around that type of person. Whenever I'm around that person, man, they get me inspired. I agree. I have an attitude of gratitude. And pretty soon, you start feeling that way. You're not complaining anymore. You're saying, man, I'm so grateful for my family. I'm so grateful for my kids. I'm so grateful for this life that I have. I am so grateful for living in this country. I know there's a lot of division in this country, but America is still the land of opportunity. It's the land of freedom. I can worship wherever I want to worship. I can go wherever I want to go. I live in this wonderful, great country, and I have amazing opportunities. All I have to do is just work hard and take advantage of those opportunities. I am extremely grateful. I am so thankful. You will start talking that way as well. So you want to hang around with people that are inspired, that are passionate, that are motivated, and that are grateful. And the final thing is, the ones that are open-minded. That's important. The mind is like a parachute. It only works when it's open. Sometimes people are just completely closed-minded, and it's like, I only want to be around these type of people. I am unfriending everybody else, and I only want to be around these people. I don't like anybody else. If they don't believe the way that I do, they're bad human beings. I am 100% correct. I want nothing to do with anybody else. I've got it all figured out. Even they believe different than me, they're disqualified. They have a different background. I don't want to be around them. I am completely closed-minded to everything. Even in the business, they might do it. They might say, well, I've done this my whole life. This is the way I've been doing it. I don't want to open up to any other opportunities. This is the way we do it, and that's final. I see churches do that, and it's like, that's not the way we've done it here before. We're not changing. You know, this is the way. This is my church, and I pay money for this church, and I'm not changing. And if you guys change anything, then I am not going. I'm leaving, and I'm going to another church, and I'm bringing my bad attitude there. That happens. They're completely closed-minded to anything that's new. And if you're going to be that way, you're going to watch success pass you by. Very important that we're open-minded to changes, to new opportunities, to new things, and that we understand that people are different. So surround yourself with people that are open-minded. They have the attitude and the philosophy that they may be different from me, but you know what? I can learn something from that person. They might have a different political background. That doesn't mean they're a bad human being. All right? They may be of different religion or a different race. They might be from the North. I'm from the South, or you're from the South or the Midwest. They might be from another country, but I'm open-minded. I want to get to know them more. And I want to learn more about their history, about their culture. I am open-minded to meeting as many new faces that I possibly can so I can learn and grow and become a better human being and be able to understand more. When you surround yourself with people like that are open-minded, then you're going to grow That's the type of people that you want to be around. So I'm going to take a short break. We're going to close. We're going to do a quick summary, and we're going to encourage you to make sure you surround yourself with the right positive people. So let's take a short break. I'll be right back with the closing. Hey, it's Rich Norton with Retriever Merchant Solutions. I want to thank all of you for watching our shows. We're hearing a lot of great positive feedback, and I'm hearing a lot from different representatives from other merchant service companies, which is fantastic. And people are telling me, man, we've got sales teams watching your shows, but I want to be on your team. And how do I get started? How do I qualify? How can I work with your company? I love what you're doing. I love the people. I love all the shows. You guys have a lot of enthusiasm. You have a lot of direction, a lot of discipline, and great things are happening. I'm seeing representatives win trips, and I want to have that lifestyle. I want to be part of a team like that, because many of the representatives that we're talking to are coming from other merchant service companies, and no big deal, nothing bad against them, but a lot of stories that I'm hearing is that they're feeling like they're lone rangers. They started out with a company and they got a little bit of training, maybe watched a couple videos, and then they're kind of thrown out there like, go out there and do it, good luck, you're on your own, and that's it. And a lot of them are falling flat on their face, they're struggling along, they're putt-putting along, and they're getting kind of discouraged. Well, I want you to know at Retriever Merchant Solutions, especially within my group, the RPS Super Group, you will never feel that way. We are here for your success. What separates us from everybody else is that we put a lot of time, a lot of effort, and we work together as a team. We will make sure that you're going to have great success as long as you're willing to put forth the effort. Now, people may say, what is the key to success? How am I going to have success in your industry? I want to be successful. Well, it's bottom line, two things. It's all about attitude. I always say this, attitude, attitude, attitude. Believe in what you're doing. I can put all that as one thing. And go to work. Attitude, belief, go to work. All right, if you do that, you're going to have great success. So if you're looking for an amazing opportunity and you want to join a winning team, give me a call. The email is right here, you'll see that. But also you can call me directly. You can call me on my cell phone, 904-434-4635. You can shoot me a text, I'll get back with you. I keep busy, but I will get back with you. And you can join a winning team, and we will help you have all your dreams come true. All right, my friends, I am back and I am very excited. I hope this stuff helps you. It ministers to me too as well. And sometimes we have to have a checkup from the neck up and make sure that we are surrounding ourselves with the right people. So again, you're a product of your own environment. Again, I don't want you to just disqualify people and tell them they're no good or you're better than them. Please hear me out on that. Just make sure that whoever you meet, you're kind, you're respectful, you encourage them. But that circle of influence is very, very important. So let's review that. Are the people that you are hanging around with inspiring? Are they passionate? Are they motivated? Are they grateful? And are they open-minded? All right? Now, I'm going to ask the same question about you, because we don't want other people to say that you're not that type of person. If you're not, you know, again, we never arrive. We always want to keep improving and keep expanding our lives to a better place. So it's our goal to make sure that we're at that level as well. What type of person are you? Are you that, hey, so-and-so is here, or are you, oh no, they're here? Real important. So you got to really test yourself right there. Are you inspiring? Are you passionate? Are you motivated? Are you grateful? And do you have an open mind? I don't claim that I've arrived and I got all this down. I need improvement in all areas myself. That's part of growing. That's all part of life. And that's what I talked about earlier. In order to have joy and happiness, we have to keep on growing. None of us arrive. If you wake up in the morning and you're still breathing, it's a new gift, and you want to keep getting better. You want to keep on improving. So make sure that you are with people that are in life where you want to be. Make sure you're a good, positive influence. Go out, encourage one another, love one another. And I'm going to say that again. Be inspiring. Be passionate. Be motivated. All right? Be grateful and be open-minded. Be that type of person that other people want to hang around with. That's my goal for you. That's my goal for myself. If you do that, you're going to have an amazing, abundant life, and you're going to have all the success that you want. Doesn't mean that life's going to be easy, but you will get through it a lot better by doing it this way. So I hope that helps you. Remember, every day that we have here on this earth is a gift. It's an absolute gift, and as I get older, I see that even more. It's an absolute gift. What you do with this day from your gift from God is your gift back to God. So make sure you make it a blessed one. Go out and encourage each other, bless one another, and love one another, and make it a great day. I'll see you next time on RMS Sales Training and Inspiration.